Good day, fellow investors. First, I really want to thank you for all the support with the book. As you can see here, we are already in great company with Nobel Prize winners. So on the total sales of stock market investing books, we are doing very, very good. I just want to answer a few comments that I find interesting for everybody. The first one is my Hister. We can see here his portfolio allocation: 36% physical gold, 33% cash, 17% gold and commodity stocks, uranium fertilizers, 11% other shares, 3% utilities. He realizes it's a lot of gold in his portfolio, and I think it's a bit overweight because, okay, you're then really timing a market crash, you're really timing a recession, and you're really timing for more quantitative easing that will allow for the gold hedge to work well and for the cash to buy new assets. However, in the meantime, the gold doesn't yield anything, and if it doesn't go up, then the portfolio might be hit very, very hardly. Nevertheless, the gold was bought in 2016, so it was a good investment up till now, so that's okay. However, portfolio allocation, when you think about portfolio allocation, try to really diversify. Try to really diversify among classes. If you are too much overweight one class, one asset class like gold, it's a very, very risky allocation. Then on the video on Kraft Heinz, very good comments there, value-adding comments. So you can see that Spiritlish says that owns both Kraft Heinz and AT&T for the dividends, great investments, great yield, appreciation over the long term, plus General Electric to be added here. And the key is there, the brands. The brands are undervalued at the moment, according to Spiritlish, and you have to see, okay, what will happen in the future. If you can see something that others don't see, then it makes those investments a great investment. And I must say that there is definitely potential for Kraft Heinz to grow strongly in the future, especially if they manage to dominate the emerging markets where they are starting their expansion now. We'll see how it ends. It's a very interesting situation. And the third comment from Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response Passion. He asks that if he rents a flat and he buys a real estate property to rent out, it looks like a loss of money for him in the short term. Doesn't it sound better to buy a house for myself and finish pay off the mortgage and just after that buy a real estate property? Now, with real estate, the key is to really check everything from a personal situation. What's my rent? What's my mortgage? Or what can be my mortgage? What's better? How do I come out ahead after 30 years? That's the key what you have to look for. Is what I buy, can it be rented out? Can it be sold later? Will it appreciate? Will it depreciate? Does it have a moat, etc., etc.? So much goes into real estate investing that it's crazy how much thought has to go into that, but it's worthwhile. So thank you for watching. Check my book if you haven't. I'll be going on a short vacation, so I'll see you probably in the new video on Sunday, when we will discuss Disney.